Hi, I'm Karah Preiss, and this is Talk Nerdy to Me, the HuffPost science show in which we boldly go where scientists have gone before. Ted Cruz just resigned from the GOP race, all but handing the Republican nomination to Donald Trump.
So finding potentially habitable planets in the universe is super important.
I mean, we gotta get the fuck out of here. Good news is that an international team of astronomers from MIT and the University of Liège in Belgium discovered not one, but three potentially habitable planets. The project that discovered these planets is called TRAPPIST.
So TRAPPIST is actually it's a survey mission, but it's an acronym for the Transiting Planets and Planetesimal Small Telescopes. And this is a 60-centimeter robotic telescope that is located in Chile. TRAPPIST has two main goals. First, search for comets and asteroids in the solar system. And second, search for planets in other solar systems.
These guys, operating out of the University of Liège in Belgium, are studying what are called ultra-cool dwarf stars.
An ultra-cool dwarf star is not, as the name suggests, some Euro EDM DJ.
It's exactly what it sounds like it is. It's a very small star, just a little bit bigger than Jupiter, less than a thousandth as bright as the sun. They're kind of the runts of the cosmos, and they're studying about 60 of them using a small telescope in Chile.
Why these ultra cool dwarf stars? They're not big and they're not bright.
In the past, people wouldn't look at these little dwarf stars in general, but it turns out that these runts of the litter have planets. And this one that they just found has not just one, but we already know of three planets. You know, the kind of planet that might have an ocean, an atmosphere, maybe some biology.
I asked Seth where scientists were looking for life before.
In the past, when we considered looking for planets that might have some inhabitants, we were always looking for planets around stars that are sort of like the sun. Nobody thought to look at these dim bulbs of the universe, these dwarf stars. In order for a planet to be habitable around a dwarf star, it has to have a really tight orbit. Otherwise, it's going to just be too cold. Any oceans would just be solid ice all the time. If it's really orbiting in close, it's locked into an orbit where one side's always facing the star, the other side's always away from the star, so it's too hot on one side, too cold on the other side. Today, we know there'll also be a Goldilocks zone around the middle. These planets that were recently found are not only, you know, at the right distance to be habitable, but this whole system's only 40 light years away. Pretty close by astronomical standards, so we might learn more about this system.
What does this discovery mean for the search for intelligent life?
This is encouraging news, because what it's saying is, look, at least there's a lot of real estate out there that could have alien life. So that's good news for us.
If you're anything like me, you don't spend your days wondering what's out there. It might be a thought that crosses your mind every time you see a movie like Interstellar or The Martian, but most lay people are not consumed by the possibility of extraterrestrial life in the faraway galaxies. Still, it is important that we recognize that we are living in a time where we could potentially unlock previously unknown details about cosmic real estate. And when you really take a moment to think about it, it wouldn't be that crazy for there to be other habitable planets outside of Earth. We will explore many more of these hard to believe but vital scientific findings in future episodes of Talk Nerdy to Me. And if you want to talk nerdy to me, do it in the comments.